Okay, this is T90, the plastic limit of soils. So we remember when we are getting our sample prepped for the liquid limit soil, we are going to take a 10 gram sample of material. Once it has attained a plastic state, and store it in a sealed container. From this 10 gram sample, we're going to pull off approximately a 2 gram subsample of this. We'll put the remainder back in a container and seal it. We're going to have a 2 gram subsample. It's going to be about the size of a pea. And we are going to roll it into an ellipsoidal shape, and then we're ready to begin. So we are going to place this onto a frosted glass surface. And what we are trying to accomplish here is we are simply going to roll this out with our hands. And we want to roll it at a rate of approximately 80 to 90 strokes per minute. And all we are trying to do is roll this out till it is 1/8 inch in diameter. We have this reference tool here that is 1/8 inch in diameter, or the pin from your liquid limit device is also 1/8 inch in diameter. So we roll it out to 1/8 an inch. And once we have achieved 1/8 of an inch, which I have here, we simply reincorporate this back into an ellipsoidal shape. And we do it again. You want to be careful with how much pressure you put on this. What we're trying to do here is roll this out until we achieve a point where it begins to break and crumble before we reach that 1/8 inch in diameter. But we don't want to apply too much pressure and force it to break. We want it to do that naturally and on its own. So we've gotten to 1/8 of an inch again. We will reincorporate it into a ribbon or an ellipsoidal shape again. And we just continue this process again until we can't roll it anymore. It begins to break apart, crumble, and we can't roll it. And I'm almost there. So as we see now, it's beginning to crumble. It's beginning to fall apart. I can't roll it anymore. It's breaking to pieces, and we have not achieved 1/8 of an inch. So we will then take these crumbles and we will put them into a teared container of known weight, and we seal it. And we then repeat this process, taking another 2 gram ball off of this 10 gram sample. And we repeat this process until the entire 10 gram sample is used up, and we have all of our soil crumbles into our teared container. We then weigh those crumbles. We get our wet weight. And then we dry this in accordance with T255, T265 to get our moisture content. And to calculate plastic limit, all it is the moisture content of this material rounded to a whole number. To get plasticity index, you would take your liquid limit, subtract your plastic limit from that, and get your plasticity index, and again, that will be a whole number. That concludes T89, T90, liquid limit, and plastic limit.